Hello, my name is Annie Lalla. I'm a love and relationship coach, and welcome to this video. Today I want to show you a piece of art that lives on top of my bed. You've seen it before maybe, but I just want to point out what it actually is. It's a woman whose face is very serene, very calm in repose, but flying out of her heart is an eagle, an apex predator. And this was actually made as a commission. My husband and I commissioned it from an amazing artist named Hans Waller. And we commissioned it for our daughter. We wanted it to be an emblem for her to aspire to. One of the things that was really important for our daughter to grow up with is a sense of relaxed, calm energy with an ability to unleash power that was congruent and effective at making change in the world. They usually don't go together. Calm, congruent, power. So I just want to talk about that today, especially as women. A lot of time we think power has to come from amped up, dysregulated nervous systems. But I'm suggesting that actually, anger, when it's rooted in a sacred truth that you believe congruently across all levels of your being, when you express that anger, it has a precision and intensity that can cut through anything. This is the Kali part of woman. Kali isn't efforting or trying. She is just being her truth, and her truth can cut through illusion, can cut through bullshit, can cut through lacks of integrity. And I guess what I want to say today is your forcefulness, your intensity is your aliveness. And very often as women, we've been taught to tamp down or push down that intensity. And in my experience helping people develop relationships, and in particular in the dating scene, one of the things I've realized that men are looking for in a woman, they'll never tell you this, and they don't even know this themselves, but what every man is looking for in a mate is a woman who helps give him more access to his own aliveness. And how does one feel our aliveness? We feel them through the spectrum of human emotion, everything from terror, fear, insecurity, jealousy, confusion, all the way to joy, delight, ecstasy, the full spectrum of human emotion. The more you can occupy and move along that spectrum, the more alive you are. And so a man falls in love with the most alive woman he can find, the most alive, not the most complacent, not the most happy, not the most agreeable. He may like those women to date and have a little rendezvous with, but the one he wants to mate with and build a life with is the one that's the most alive. Why? Because he wants to feel the most alive in his body, in his life. And who better to help him with that than the most alive woman he's ever met? So why am I telling you this? It's so that you realize that the full gamut of your human emotions are what's most attractive to him. And I want to give you permission to feel all the different feelings that come up for you and to be able to express them. Now the trick, especially with the more difficult negative feelings like anger, frustration, overwhelm, rage, those feelings can be difficult to express. Sometimes they just feel too scary in our body, but also those feelings can be difficult to express because they always get accompanied with shame, blame, and make wrong. So the trick as a woman is to be able to express your negative feelings to your partner while hygienically cleaning off the shame, blame, and make wrong. See, as soon as you do shame, blame, and make wrong, a man's defenses come up. And he's busy defending himself rather than listening to the truth underneath your emotion. So how do we do that? We look for shoulds. You should have. Clean off the should. A should is a could with shame smeared on top. We go into, if you get angry as a woman and there's something that's frustrating you, you literally report, I'm angry right now. Or if you can't even say the words angry, report on your body sensations. I feel tightness in my throat. I feel nausea in my chest. I feel a tension in my shoulders. And then say to him, when you said, when you did, I felt. So instead of you made me feel angry, it's when you left the door open, I noticed my throat tightened, I got contracted in my chest, and I felt nausea and anxiety moving through me. That makes them get curious because you're not attacking them. You're saying, when you did this thing, my body had this response. They are very interested in your body's responses. They're not very interested in you making them wrong and the cause of your experience. Remember, as women, we have to own the autonomy of our own experience. I felt when you did. Let them get curious about what in what they did caused anxiety in my woman's throat or tension in her shoulders. It pulls on their curiosity. When you say, you made me feel bad, you hurt me, you did this, it does not pull on their curiosity, it pulls on their defensiveness. So to summarize, all your feelings are sacred. Each one of them is an art piece. Each one of them has an intelligence and a dignity and something to say. And if you want to express your emotions to your partner, you have to express them first to yourself and honor them as having some beauty in them. So if there are emotions that you have, like shame or fear, and you don't see their own magnificence, then you won't be able to express that to your partner. And what comes out of that is you won't be able to help your partner learn to accept and love his own emotions. So as a woman, what we need to do is honor all our emotions, like each one is one of our children. They're all welcome at the dinner table. They all get a voice. They all get a microphone. The more you do that with your man, the more you give him permission to do that with his emotions. And that's what a man is really looking for. Finally, somewhere in this universe, all of his feelings are welcome. All of his feelings have a chance to get expressed. The only place in this universe where he has a chance of feeling fully expressed in his emotional spectrum is around a woman who can do that with her emotions. So my invitation to you is to practice being a woman that is expressing all her emotions, but doing it in such of a way that allows her man to feel curious and interested in them rather than defended and avoidant. Okay? So hopefully you learned something from this video. If all you learned is that your anger is sacred and your confusion is sacred and your frustration is sacred, and when you express it to your partner, express it as if it is a sacred offering. And I believe they will feel that and take it in accordingly. All right, leave any questions or comments below. Thank you for listening. Tune in next time.